now with y axis, v1 makes y 30 degree angle with the y axis in the downward direction. Okay, so that is v1 direction. What is v1? You can calculate, because already you know what is your 2 a3 etc. You can calculate the magnitude, that's not issue, but I'm just telling the directions. You can easily find out the direction. A2 cross a3 will give you p1. Similarly, your b2 will be a3 cross a1. If you do a3 cross a1, just take a3 is perpendicular to the screen. If you do a3 cross a1, what will happen? You will get a direction along b2, which is perpendicular to a1. Which is perpendicular to a1. But now this b2 makes 30 degree angle with y axis in the positive direction above. And this one is making, probably my drawing was not so right. It doesn't look like both are making 30 degree. Actually, b2 makes 30 degree angle, the positive side of y axis, and this is also 30 degree angle. So now v1, b2 have an angle 60 degree. That means, your hexagonal lattice, you can define it either way. You can say hexagonal lattice means a1 is equal to a2 is equal to a, and not equal to a3. But angle between A1 and A2 is 120 degree or 60 degree also. Either way you can define. Some textbooks define it as 60 degree, some textbooks take it as 120 degree. That doesn't matter. You will always produce hexagonal lattice. So now angle between B1 and B2 is 60 degree. But what about B3? B3 will remain in the same direction, the perpendicular direction. That doesn't change, because that is actually B3 is A1 cross A2. A1 cross A2, if you do, that's perpendicular to the this only. Its magnitude will change. So B3 is along A3 only, that doesn't change. Okay, only difference is A1, A2 vectors have 120 degree, B1, B2 vectors have 60 degree now. But both are hexagonal lattice, both will generate the hexagonal lattice. So when you define two lattice vectors, instead of taking A1, A2 as 120 degree, I can also take A1, A2 with 60 degree also. If somebody starts with 60 degree A1, A2, he will generate actually 120 degree B1, B2. That's what will happen. Can check it if you like. So anyway, that doesn't matter. You started with A1, A2, 120 degree, you got B1, B2 with 60 degree, and A3 remains, B3 remains in the same direction as A3. So then, but both these primitive lattice vectors will generate the same lattice one. There is no, this will again generate hexagonal lattice. Okay. So there is whether 60 or 120, lattice will be same. Maybe how these lattice parameters will differ, because we are talking about reciprocal lattice. If you want exact magnitudes, you can find out later. Let us not worry about it now. You can actually substitute A2 and A3, you can get the values. That's not important. Just you have to understand that. Start with 120 degree original Bravais lattice. You will get a reciprocal lattice with 60 degree. If you start with 60 degree, you will go back to 120 degree. But both are hexagonal lattices. Okay. Now let's see reciprocal lattice vector and interplanar space, how they are related. Okay, so if you want to relate interplanar spacing and reciprocal lattice vector, magnitude of reciprocal lattice vector, let's say that suppose I have shown you two planes actually here, which are separated by a distance d. Okay, and because we have infinitely many planes in this set, but I have taken particular two planes, and on these two planes there is a reciprocal lattice vector corresponding to this set of planes g that is perpendicular to the planes that we know already. Is the reciprocal lattice vector perpendicular to the planes. Now, I take one, because these are planes. Planes means what? These are Bravais lattice planes actually. That means there are some Bravais lattice points on that plane. I take a particular Bravais lattice point here, the first plane. And the other plane also, I take a Bravais lattice point. I connect them. Because both are Bravais lattice points, if you connect them, you will get a Bravais lattice vector, right? You can get a Bravais lattice vector, Ri. Now, I want to see what is the projection of R along G, because we have two planes which are perpendicular, but R is not perpendicular to the planes. R is at some angle. We can draw it even at much higher, because this plane is infinite. You can take R anything actually, any lattice point you take, it doesn't matter. You can define very steeply going R vector also. Now if you take the projection of R along G, and whenever you want to take a projection of vector along a particular direction, you just have to take R at vector dot this unit vector along the direction actually. In whichever direction you are taking the projection, you must dot product with the corresponding unit vector. G cap is the unit vector along G actually. That's mathematics. There is no reciprocal lattice here. This is a mathematical definition. So that's R dot G cap will be D. D is the distance actually between the planes. or this can be written as r dot g by magnitude of g, because if you multiply magnitude of g and divide it, you will get unit vector will become normal vector g, that r dot g by g is equal to g. But what is r dot g? That's 2 pi n from our definition of reciprocal lattice. 2 pi n by g, that is r g is equal to 2 pi n by d. If n is equal to 1, that gives the shortest reciprocal lattice vector. Or you can have n is equal to 2, 3, etc. That is 4 pi by d, 6 pi by d, 6 pi by d, etc. It will go. Or you can have negative values also, because g cannot only go in one direction, because this is a reciprocal lattice and can take any values, including 0. But if you put 0, that is g is equal to 0, that means actually it is the origin. So origin is not, we cannot call it the shortest reciprocal lattice vector. So first, starting with the reciprocal lattice vector, finite vector, we need. Okay. So g, n is equal to 0 will give you the origin of the reciprocal space. Okay, if n is equal to 1, g sh means the short, is equal to 2 pi by t. If the shortest reciprocal lattice vectors corresponding to planes with interplanar spacing d is 2 pi by t. That is the shortest one. But you can have many, as I said, and keep on increasing, you will get many vectors in that direction. That is different. Because you cannot have only one vector for one given planes, you can have shortest vector. If you have only one vector, then it will not form a lattice actually. You should have infinitely many reciprocal lattice vectors in any given direction. So that's 2 pi by d. So this we are going to use. Suppose you want to find d in some cases, you can call it as d is equal to 2 pi by g sh. If you can find the shortest reciprocal lattice vector, you can immediately find d actually. In some cases, finding interplanar spacing becomes extremely difficult, because for cubic systems or orthorhombic it is okay, because your axes are orthogonal. But if the axes are not orthogonal, how will you find the d h? It's not possible in real space. You have to use only the g reciprocal lattice. Then just make it 2 pi by g shortest reciprocal lattice. That will give you d h. That is the way we can find for the hexagonal lattice. Once we know that the shortest reciprocal lattice vector, just make it 2 pi by g. Okay. So this, I think, it is clear that shortest reciprocal lattice vector for a set of planes with interplanar spacing d is 2 pi by d. Just remember that. Okay. So now, suppose orientation of a plane can be specified by the direction cosines of the normal to the plane. Yes, that is always true. This is not, I think, a vehicle axis. It's a three-dimensional geometrical statement actually. If you want to specify the orientation of a plane, you don't have to worry about the actual plane. You only worry about its normal. If you know the direction cosines of the normal, that will specify the orientation of the plane. But now we know in these lattices, we have reciprocal lattice vector, right? Reciprocal lattice vector, that is normal to the lattice planes. So that means that normal, whatever I said here, we can use the normal is nothing but the reciprocal lattice. But if you have HKL planes, if you have planes HKL, this normal vector, because I told you yesterday in some point, I think I will define this plane. If you have Ax plus by plus cz is equal to d, the plane, its normal vector will be abc vector. Similarly, for HKL plane, its normal vector will be hb1 plus kb2 plus lb3. Okay. hb1 plus kb2 plus lb3, that is the shortest reciprocal lattice vector, because HKL have no common vector. HKL are the Miller indices. That's why these Miller indices are related to shortest reciprocal lattice. Yesterday somebody was asking that. Yes, Miller indices are related to shortest reciprocal lattice vector. Okay, so g short vector can be written like hb1 plus kb2 plus lb3. But what is the magnitude of gsh? That's 2 pi by d. That is still right. But can we find the magnitude from this? It's not that simple, because we do not know what are the angles between b1, b2, b3 in general. Okay, they may not be orthogonal. They are not orthogonal in general case. And also they are not unit vectors. Cannot write just a square root of a square plus k square plus l square. No, that's not the magnitude. Don't think that way. Okay, that doesn't work actually. Because b1, b2, b3 may not be orthogonal systems. Okay, so for the shortest reciprocal lattice vector HKL, because of the when you write reciprocal lattice vector, shortest one, hb1 plus kb2 plus lb3, HKL being the Miller indices, they should not have any common factor. But if you want to write other reciprocal as well. Suppose you have 2 pi by d, then you have 4 pi by d. If you write for the other reciprocal as well, then there may be common factors. Otherwise, for shortest one, there are no common factors. Yeah. Now, so one point I just forgot to mention in between should have been done. Volume of ring tensor in direct and reciprocal axis. If you take direct lattice, what is the volume of the ring tensor? A1 dot A2 plus A3, right? A1 dot A2 plus A3, that is the volume of the ring tensor in direct lattice. Let us call it as V. Okay. Then if you call that as V, your B1 dot B2 cross B3. We have already derived this in between, it came actually. One of the slides it is there. That is B1 dot 2 pi whole square by D into A1, that is B2 cross B3 is becoming like that. That will be 2 pi whole cube by D. This result was there in one of the slides. So let us call this B1 dot B2 cross B3. What is B1 dot B2 cross B3? That is the volume of the printing cell in the reciprocal lattice. Because the primitive lattice vectors multiply. So that let us call it as VR. Volume of the primitive cell reciprocal lattice is VR. That is 2 pi whole cube by V. That they are related this way. So they are also inverse. And it means 2 pi whole cube is the factor. That 2 pi whole cube is coming because you have defined your reciprocal lattice with primitive vectors with 2 pi factor. V1 is for 2 pi, V2 cross A3. That 2 pi factor is coming here. If you don't take that vector, you will get VR is equal to 1 by V simply. Okay. So VR is the reciprocal lattice primitive cell volume is equal to 2 pi whole cube by the volume of the primitive cell in direct lattice. That's the way these two are related actually. I think that's okay. So now let me stop it here. Okay, because this ends the reciprocal lattice. I mean, some problems we may solve later. Otherwise, I want to solve this reciprocal lattice thing. If you have some questions now, please you may ask.
Good afternoon, sir. So myself, Swati.
Yeah, please.
Sir, you said that reciprocal lattice is equivalent to, is same as Breuer lattice.
No, I'm not saying equal. No, I'm not saying equivalent. See, when you have a Breuer lattice,
yes,
you find its reciprocal. That yes, is sir. Also having all, that will also satisfy all the properties of some Breuer lattice, not the same Breuer lattice. You will not get, suppose I told you, I've shown one example. Suppose VCC if you take,
yes,
you
sir.
Can reciprocate it, you will get FCC. You are not getting the same Breuer lattice, but it is also a Breuer lattice. Yes.
Yes, sir.
It satisfies all the properties of some Breuer lattice, not the same Breuer lattice. No. If it satisfies the same Breuer lattice, then the reciprocal is also same. No, I'm not saying yes. They are not equivalent.
So I'm asking, sir, why there is a need to find such complicated reciprocal lattice and all? If we have Breuer lattice,
the problem is like this. It's not that somebody wants to find. Suppose when you say plane wave, I told you actually, e power ik dot r you are writing, right? G dot r or something. See,
yes,
whether you want it or not, r is the reciprocal, position vector in the real space, right? K
yes,
is
sir.
In the reciprocal space automatically. It's not that if somebody wants it. Whenever you write a plane wave or anything, you get that automatically. Okay. But here what will happen is, suppose for example, let me tell you why I can at least give you an example. Mm-hmm. Suppose I want you to find this interplanar spacing.
Right? Yes, sir.
Hexagonal lattice. Okay,
yes, sir.
Try to find out in the direct lattice. And
yes, sir.
The same thing in reciprocal lattice, it will become very, very simple in reciprocal lattice. A lot of things will become like that, not only this. Okay, in the reciprocal lattice, many things will become simpler. Maybe there are certain things which are easier in Breuer lattice compared to reciprocal. But there are a lot of things which are very, very difficult to deal in direct
yes,
lattice. Yeah. I have one example I told you.
Okay, sir.
And also, for example, you talk about band structure of materials. Okay. So when
yes,
you say
sir.
Band structure, that is actually K space, it is reciprocal space only. You never have band structure in direct space actually. In Breuer lattice. No. That is always in reciprocal space. Because you plot K versus E, right? That's for band structure. E versus
yes,
K, E versus K, E versus KZ. This KX, KY, KZ are nothing but reciprocal lattice vectors.
So yes, sir.
Whole solid state physics, if you just leave out first few chapters, it is only case space actually. Reciprocal case.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Hello, sir. Sir, I am Shahrukh.
So yesterday you asked.
So I have a question, sir. We have seen that we can easily calculate the reciprocal lattice for a three-dimensional dimensional direct lattice. But if I have a two-dimensional lattice vectors like
An A1 and A2,
so for A3 we always take only k cap.
That's key. Actually, you can calculate without taking vector along k cap also. Okay, because see, that's only for convenience we are taking, because you want to use the same logic where b1 is equal to a2 cross a3. This set you want to use, you know, that's why you are using. Then without doing that, you can find reciprocal lattice vectors in two dimensions. But that may be more complicated. Mathematically, you have to do more. But if you apply this logic, just assume that there is a vector perpendicular to this, which is not there actually. You are giving it, right?
Actually, sir, my question is that if I don't take any A3 vector that is along k cap, then how do I find the unit cell volume from our information?
No, that's not unit cell, unit cell area. You can find straight. Unit cell area can be found.
Okay, but sir, unit cell area, if I found the unit cell area, then it is area is a vector, but volume is a scalar quantity.
No, area is not a vector, just a minute. Area is not a vector. You can define vector area, that is different. Vector area concept is different. But area in general is not a vector. It is magnitude of A1 cross A2, you can say that is the area. Area is always a positive quantity. It is not a vector. But you can define vector area is defined for many purposes where you calculate the flux, etc., flux density, integral E dot ds, etc. There you use the concept of vector area. Vector area is different. Okay. Vector area is always taken here. A vector perpendicular to the direction of the area with the same magnitude as area. That is vector area. That's not required for you now. Just calculate A1 cross A2. If you have suppose two vectors A1 and A2, you calculate A1 cross A2 with the magnitude. That is the area of the primitive cell actually. In two dimensions.
Yes.
So now you don't have to go to three dimensions.
Okay, then I can easily find B2.
Yes, I will give you some problems. Actually, I'll show you also how to do maybe in the next class sometimes. I can take some two-dimensional lattices. We can do this very easy. Because see, two-dimensional